friend. What I would like to do is, with your help, welcome up here a young lady who's retiring today. So, Mrs. Maringola, will you come up, please? If you don't know, you should know by now, Mrs. Maringola works in the attendance office in the main office. She is retiring. Come up here. She's retiring after 23 years with Stroudsburg School District. She started as a paraprofessional in the library, moved to be an attendance secretary in the main office, moved down to athletics, if you remember, last year and the year before, moved back to attendance this year to finish out her career. During her time here, she's chaperoned many dances, assisted with fundraisers, sold tickets at football games, basketball games, field hockey, and has participated in this show, actually, many, many times as a Wolfette and as a Who in the Grinch skit. She has served as the treasurer for a celebration team that we have on staff. She lives with her two daughters and has three grand puppies. And in her retirement, she plans on traveling and visiting friends and family out of state and spending a lot of time at the beach. So help me congratulate Mrs. Maringola on a great career. We'll be right back.
way to start off the show. So you probably noticed all throughout the town of Stroudsburg, there's snowmen all over the place. Makes me think, what do snowmen do on the weekends?
Chill out.
You just chill out. Yeah. Chill out. Hey, what do you call a shark that delivers toys on Christmas? Santa John. So now we're going to move to our first dance in the TikTok dance challenge. So remember the numbers of your favorites so you can vote later. Here's TikTok dance number one.
So just before Christmas, there was
people in an elevator. There's an honest politician. There's a generous lawyer. And there's Santa Claus. And they're riding in an elevator, and the elevator door is open, and there's a $20 bill laying on the ground. Which one of them picks it up? You're right, Santa Claus. You know why? The other two don't exist. That takes us into TikTok dance number two.
Hold up.
So we've got to set up a little bit for the next act. What should we do? Jokes! Sure, we can do some jokes. So, where do polar bears vote? At the North Pole. Now, even though we're heading into break, it's no time to let your grades slide. I heard Santa wasn't too pleased with Rudolph's report card. You know why? He went down in history. Does anybody know what a Christmas tree's favorite candy is? Ornaments. Got the microphones out. Very good. We're going to be ready for our next act. Gracing us on the stage, Mr. Steve Rivera and the Bells. Mr. Steve Rivera and the Bells.
Oh,
So, tell me, what's the difference between Santa's reindeer and a knight in shining armor? Well, one slays a dragon, the other's a dragon to slay.
Thank you. Yeah.
Well, if Santa found himself in the South Pole, what would you call him?
Be a lost
cause. Be a lost cause, yeah. Probably know this one. What do you call a frog hanging from the ceiling at Christmas time? A mistletoad. So far, the acts have all been staff members, but we know that among student body, we have an incredible amount of talent. Putting that on display for us right now is your own show choir. Shellfish. for number six.
Thank you. the female faculty dancers. Put your hands together for them.
Great job, ladies. Anybody know what Santa's elves learn in school? The alphabet. You know, the holidays always help me reveal my superpower. I'm able to look at a wrapped present and tell you what's in it. It's a gift. So now we're up to TikTok dance number 7. Keep them straight, you're gonna be voting. TikTok dance number 7, here we go. Cuff it.
Learn to depend on you.
what Jack Frost's favorite day at school is? Snow and tell. Any idea why Dasher and Dancer love coffee so much? Well, because they're Santa's Starbucks. So, I think we now have TikTok dance number 8 on tap. Here we go, this is number 8. Number 8 on tap. Here we go, this is number 8.
Such a great one.
So, who can tell me what's a bird's favorite Christmas story? The Finch Who Stole Christmas. Hey, what did the big furry hat say to the warm woolly scarf? You hang around while I go on ahead. Hey, why did Frosty the Snowman want a divorce? He thought his wife was a flake. So we're down to our last TikTok dance. This is number 9. Dance number 9.
All the noise, 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 noise. They'll stand close together with Christmas bells ringing. They'll stand hand in hand, and those whos will start singing. And they'll sing, and they'll sing, and they'll sing, 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 sing. Thought of this Who Christmas Sing, the more the Grinch thought, I must stop this whole thing. Why, for 53 years, I've put up with it now. I must stop Christmas from coming. But how? Then he got an idea, an awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea. I know just what to do. The Grinch laughed in his throat. I'll make a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat. And he chuckled and clucked, what a great Grinch trick. With this coat and this hat, I look just like St. Nick. All I need is a reindeer, the Grinch looked around. But since reindeer are scarce, there was none to be found. Did that stop the Grinch? No, the Grinch simply said. If I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one instead. So he called his dog Max, and he took some red thread, and he tied a big horn on the top of his head. Then he loaded some bags, and he hitched up old Max. Then the Grinch said, giddy up! And the sleigh started down toward the homes where the Whos lay a snooze in their town. All their windows were dark, quiet snow filled the air. All the Whos were all dreaming sweet dreams without care.
Welcome to the Grinch's lair! Watching the girl and the Who's looking like. Santa suit on the dick of my hair like. Hey, 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 okay, okay, okay. Now watch my boy to the stairs. Now press on that beat, press on that beat.
This is stop number one, the old Grinchy Claus hissed. As he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist. Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pinch. But if Santa could do it, then so could the Grinch. He got stuck only once for a minute or two. Then he stuck his head out of the fireplace flue, where the little Who stockings hung all in a row. These stockings, he grinched, are the first things to go.
You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart's an empty hole. Your brain is four-sided. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. I would touch you with a 39.5-foot pole.
Then he slithered and slunk with a smile most unpleasant around the whole room, and he took every present. Pop guns and bicycles, roller skates, drums, checkerboards, tricycles, popcorns, and plums. And he stuffed them in bags, then the Grinch very nimbly stuffed all of the bags one by one up the chimney. Then he slunk to the icebox. He took the Who's feast. He took the Who pudding. He took the roast beast. He cleaned out that icebox as quick as a flash. Why, that Grinch even took their last can of Who hash. Then he stuffed all the food up the chimney with glee. And now, grinned the Grinch, I will stuff up the tree. And the Grinch grabbed the tree and he started to shove. When he heard a small sound, like the coo of a dove. He turned around fast and he saw a small Who. Little Cindy Lou Who, who was not more than two. The Grinch had been caught by this tiny Who daughter, who'd gotten out of bed for a cup of cold water.
She stared at the Grinch and said, Santa Claus, why? Why are you taking our Christmas tree? Why?
But you know that old Grinch was so smart and so slick. He thought up a lie and he thought it up quick. Why, my sweet little tot, the fake Santa Claus lied. There's a light on this tree that won't light on one side. So I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there, then I'll bring it back here. And his fib fooled the child. Then he patted her head. And he got her a drink and he sent her to bed. And when Cindy Lou Who went to bed with her cup, he went to the chimney and stuffed the tree up. Then the last thing he took was the log for their fire. Then he went up the chimney himself, the old liar. On their walls he left nothing but hooks and some wire. And the one speck of food that he left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse. Then he did the same thing to the other Who's houses, leaving crumbs much too small for the other Who's mouses. It was a quarter of dawn, all the Who's still abed. All the Who's still a snooze when he packed up his sled. Packed it up with their presents, their ribbons, their wrappings, their snoof, and their fuzzles, their tringlers and trappings. 10,000 feet up, up the side of Mount Crumpet, he rode with his load to the tip-top to dump it. Just waking up, I know just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang open a minute or two. Then the Who's down in Whoville will all cry, boo-hoo. That's a noise, grinned the Grinch, that I simply must hear. He paused and the Grinch put a hand to his ear. And he did hear a sound rising over the snow. It started in low, then it started to grow. But this sound wasn't sad. Why, this sound sounded glad. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all. Christmas from coming, it came. Somehow or other, it came just the same. And the Grinch with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags. He puzzled and puzzled till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then? Well, in Whoville, they say, that the Grinch's small heart grew three sizes that day. Back their floof to the
wish you a Merry Christmas. But before we do, and we hope you'll join us in singing, we have the winners of the TikTok dancing. In third place, there was a tie. Mrs. Davis and Ms. Stoffer. In second place, Mrs. Vale and Mrs. Halbert. And in first place, Mrs. Mombasa and Mrs. Nicholson. Join us, everyone.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
You